Should streamers pay for streaming games? According to one developer, yes, streamers should be required to pay the developers for the games they stream. Namaskar friends, welcome to Illegal Desi. Let's discuss this. So just a couple of days back, this controversial topic opened up because of a Google Stadia developer by the name of Alex Hutchinson, who tweeted out the following. Streamers worried about getting their content pulled because they used music they didn't pay for should be more worried by the fact that they're streaming games they didn't pay for as well. It's all gone as soon as publishers decide to enforce it. Now this, as you would expect, met with overwhelming criticism from the gaming community, with some people even going as far as to taking pot shots at him handling things at Stadia and how badly Stadia is performing right now. But this didn't just end here. He went further on to say, "Amazing to me that people are upset at someone saying that creators of the content should be allowed to make some of the money from other people using their content for profit." Now, this is a very controversial statement to make because a lot of video games, and I mean a lot of games, have benefited from streamers promoting it. If you look at some of the recent games that have been trending on YouTube or Twitch, Among Us, Fall Guys, Phasmophobia, all three of them are indie games that were promoted on YouTube, on Twitch by independent streamers, and they got wildly popular. Just taking the example of Among Us, this was a game released 2 years ago with little to no success, and all of a sudden one streamer picked it up, played it, and it got viral like anything. And on Twitch, it's among the top 5 streams that are currently being played. Now, I want to take a minute and show the hypocrisy of this person, of who he actually is, by this tweet, where right after creating a controversy on streaming, he talks about that he'll be streaming Fall Guys, who's in. Now, I'm not sure whether this guy was taking shots at those people criticizing him or he's genuinely a fan of the game. However, he must realize that Fall Guys also became wildly popular because of a lot of streamers playing the game when it launched. But I wanted to take some time and talk about the subject because streamers have been the reason why many video games have become popular, even in India. PUBG Mobile, Call of Duty Mobile, Garena Free Fire, these are some of the top games that Indian gamers stream out every single day. And I think that's one of the reasons behind their popularity and why others are getting into it. Some other games like Valorant, Apex Legends also have a great following, and old school games like League of Legends and Dota have been popular since time unknown. In my opinion, this was a very stupid comment to make because even game developers now go as far as to removing clauses from the terms of agreement that may prohibit a gamer from streaming his game out to YouTube or Twitch. Now, another interesting thing happened since yesterday was that Google actually distanced themselves from this comment. And also, we noticed that Alex Hutchinson has changed his credentials from being a developer at Google Stadia and changing it to creative director at SGNE Montreal Studio. Now, this looks like directly a result of the backlash that this guy has faced on his comments, which in my opinion, again, are nothing short of asinine. And furthermore, if you look at his profile picture, the display pic he has on his profile of Journey to the Savage Planet is actually a fan-made art of a streamer who also took to Twitter to call him out on his hypocrisy. In my opinion, gamers have already paid more than enough for the game, for the microtransactions, for the DLC and whatnot, and publishers have no right in asking them for more money for streaming these games. Furthermore, even if we take his hypothesis into consideration that streamers should pay the game developers for streaming their content, that money will never actually go to the developers. It will always go to the publishers. The biggest example of this being Activision Blizzard, Take-Two or EA, whose developers slog like anything but don't even get to see the money that these publishers make. I would also like to add on that this will also stifle new content creators in the market who are out there who are looking to stream games, because they'll also have to pay a licensing fees for all the games that they stream. And ultimately, this might result in we never discovering beautiful games like Among Us or Phasmophobia or Fall Guys, because there is simply no incentive for streamers to stream these games if they are forced to pay developers a licensing fees for streaming these games. Anyway, that was my take on this whole controversy surrounding streamers being forced to pay for streaming content developers' games. Let me know what you think on this whole scenario. If you've reached till here, I thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and the subscribe button. It helps out the channel more than you know. Do put in your thoughts in the comments so everyone, including me, can know what you feel about this whole mess. And share this video out to a friend so they also get to know what is going on in the gaming industry. And I will see you in the next one.